fuggendo l'alma del crudo amor, può ritornar la palma.
Per farne sue vendette e con arco e con saette.
fuggite, si fuggite. A chi servo d'amor diventate?
La Marseillaise.
Thank you.
les journées d'août.
C'est vous qu'on parlait de Tori, une surprise vienneuse. J'ai faux qu'un bras se jouterie de princesse de collège.
Étrange, le lourd paquet qu'il cache.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all so much for coming this evening, all six of you. It means so much that you would take time out of your busy lives to spend an evening with me, especially considering that you don't have that much time to waste. I can see by your puzzled expressions that you're wondering what I'm talking about, so I'm just going to come right out and say it. The world is ending. Now, for those of you who may have been living under a rock the past 4 years, you may want to stay there. It'll shelter you from the radiation. Yes, the world is ending. Diseases are spreading because people don't want to vaccinate their kids. Democracies all over the world are giving way to strong-arming dictatorships. And scientists say that we have, at most, 11 years to avoid complete ecological catastrophe. If all this has you feeling maybe a bit scared, perhaps a bit on edge, I'm here tonight to tell you, don't be afraid. Because we will have launched the nukes long before it comes time to worry about any of that stuff. Now, I understand that that might be of little comfort to some of you, which is why I've created this evening's final set, which I have affectionately dubbed The Apocalypse and You, Strategies for Coping with the End of the World. Tonight, we're going to be going through some of the various tips and tricks that you can use to feel just a little bit better about the grim, cackling hell that awaits us all. So without further ado, I say we dive right in. Tip number one, think happy thoughts. I don't know about you, but whenever I'm feeling scared or anxious, I like to think back to my childhood in good old Bexley, Ohio, where everything was perfect and nothing bad ever happened ever. This is a song about Bexley, and it goes like this. His business and his business only. I feel fortunate enough to have found a hobby that I am quite passionate about. And with spring being upon us, I can think of no better time to share this passion with all of you. This is a song about springtime in general, and in particular, one of the many pleasures that the coming of spring affords us all.
It's the old
The world's going to shit. There's nothing we can do about it, and we're all gonna die. Plus, if I know baby even a little, I am never gonna see that fucking gift card, believe me. I don't know. Maybe we're missing the point. I mean, everything I've sung about, all the advice I've given you tonight, has been about ways you can distract yourself from the problem, ways you can ignore the problem. But maybe the only real way to truly be happy is to just accept that this is the world we were born into, and our time is ours to choose to do with what we will. And we can spend our whole lives in fear, worrying about what tomorrow might bring, or we can spend our whole lives living. And if there's one upside to the world ending in a fiery nuclear inferno, it's that we will all go together when we go. Go directly to